In 2021, I wanted to fly the EAA's AirVenture in Oshkosh, but forest fires and TFRs along my route convinced me to stay home. Fortunately, the Northwest had a very wet spring in 2022, and no fires challenged my flight to Oshkosh this year. So, I kissed my wife, scratched my dog's ears, and headed east in my Maule. I planned to fly a crooked course to catch some airway attractions along my trip. My first stop was Ryan Field, a backcountry strip just outside the western entrance to Glacier National Park. What a marvelous place to spend a night or two. Departing Ryan Field, I flew through the Bob Marshall Wilderness and across the Continental Divide in Montana. The scenery through here is spectacular, with the Chinese Wall, Sun River, Gibson Dam, and mountains everywhere. Once past the Rockies, the tedium heat and turbulence of flying over the plains begins. Avgas across the plains frequently cost more than shown on my aviation app, and was completely unavailable in other places. It's good to land across this stretch of the country with more than the minimum reserves remaining. I spent my second night in Chamberlain, South Dakota, where the Dignity statue sits above the Missouri River. The next day, I entered the eastern edge of the plains, where more water is available and the farms are dark green with growth. Soon, the Mississippi River was under my wings, and the next thing you know, I'm in the conga line for Oshkosh, just ahead of another Maule flown from Texas by Brock, Nick, and Spencer. AirVenture has so much going on, it's hard to take it all in. I put in more than 20,000 steps per day trying to see it all, and that finally burned me out. After 5 full days at the site, I was done and headed west on Thursday. My return trip took me over some famous American landmarks, but I was glad to leave the flatlands behind and return to the western edge of the country where tall mountains meet the sea. AirVenture is a magical event with something for everyone. Both the journey there and the event itself make me so happy that Tom Rothrock taught me to fly 46 years ago.